students, welcome for today's video lecture on Ganit Pravinya. Today we are going to start the new chapter, but before that some student asked me the doubt about how to count the triangles in the given figure. See, when the given figure is in this way, I told you that just write numbers in that and add them. 1 plus 2 plus 3, that is 3 plus 2, 5 and 1, 6. There are 6 triangles. Easily we can find. Okay, but when the figure is irregular, means this triangle was just, it was divided by vertical lines, okay, and there was no other division. So just by adding the numbers, we found the triangles easily. But in like these figures, these are irregular figures. There is no specific pattern of dividing the figure. Okay. So in this case, how to count the triangles? Okay. When any trick is not applicable, how to count the triangles? See, what we have to do. Whatever parts are there, we will give numbers to them. See, for this part, 1, 2, you give 3, you will give 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8. Okay? It is not necessary that you should follow this only sequence. You can give any 1, 2, 3 here, 4 here, any way. Okay? Just we have to give, put a number in every small part. Okay? Now see how to count the triangles. First, we will find the triangles which are made up of only one number. Means for example, see this one, this part of one. Means it is it triangle? Yes, right? Similarly, see the two. Two means this part. Is it triangle? Independently, we can identify. So, we have to put the numbers. Okay? So, first we find the triangles made up of or triangles with single digit. Triangles with single digit. See the part of 1. Part of 1. Is it triangle? Yes, right here 1. Part of 2. Is it triangle? Yes. Part of 3. Is it triangle? Yeah. 4. Again 4 is also triangle. Part of 5, is it triangle? Yes. Similarly, all parts, if you see independently, individually, all are triangles, right? So here, triangles with single digit. How many triangles we are getting with single digit? Total 8 triangles. So I will write here 8 triangles. Okay. Now, triangles with two digits taken together. Okay, so I'll just write here two digits. Two digits means what? See, 1 and 2. See, together, 1 and 2, take together. So, 1 and 2, if you see this part and this part together, is it triangle? 1 and 2? Yes, it is triangle. So, 1 plus 2. Means 1 plus 2 for? This one and this one part and this and second part. So this 1 plus 2 together, it makes one triangle. Okay, so 1 plus 2 I have written here. Then 1 plus 3, this 1 and 3 together, is it triangle? Yes, correct. 1 plus 3. Then 2 plus 8, is it triangle? 2 and 8 part together? Yes. Then 3 and 8 together, is it triangle? 3 and 8? Yes, 3 and 8 also triangle. 3 plus 8. Then, 3 plus 4, is it triangle? 3 plus 4. See this part, 3 and 4 together. Is it triangle? No, it has 4 sides, no triangle. Again, similarly, 8 and 7 also no triangle. 7 and 6 also no triangle. 5 plus 6. 5 plus 6, see, 5 and 6. Is it triangle? Yes, 5 plus 6. Together they make triangle, okay? Is there any other triangle formed by two digits? No. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Total 5 triangles we got. Triangles with 2 digits. Okay. Taken together. Now triangles with 3 digits. Now see triangles with 3 digits. Which combinations are possible? Which combinations of 3 digits here, which form triangle? Now see, 5, 6 and 7, these 3 parts, observe together, 5, 6 and 7. So from here to here, here, are they forming triangle? Yes, 5, so 5 plus 6 plus 7. 5 plus 6 plus 7, together they form triangle. Similarly, 7 plus 8 plus 3. See, 7 plus 8 plus 3. Similarly, 8 plus 3 plus 4. See, 8 plus 3 plus 4. And see this, 4 plus 5 plus 6, these 3 parts, together they form triangle, correct? 4 plus 5 plus 6. Again, combination of 3 digits, which forming triangle? Is it possible? No. This much only, okay? 4 triangles. Okay? Now, combination of 5 digits together, is there any combination of 5 digits which are forming triangle? Is it possible? No, this much only, okay? 5 digits, then you can check 6 digits, total 8 digits are there. So, till 8 digits, we can try, we can check whether any triangle is getting 7 digits. No, this much only, okay? So, total how many triangles we got? These 8 triangles with 1 digit, 5 triangles with the 2 digits and 4 triangles with the 3 digits. So total 8 plus 5, 13 plus 4, 17. Total 17 triangles are there. Okay, so in this way we have to count the triangles when there is irregular figure. When there is regular figure, I have told you how to count. Okay? If you want to write this, you can pause this video and write in your notebook. Now let's move towards our new lesson, new chapter, distance, speed and time. Okay, these three concepts are co-linked with together, they are linked with each other, distance, speed and time. And you know, when we say distance, speed and time, immediately which image comes in front of our eyes? Vehicle, right? Car, bus, train, aeroplane, or a boat, okay? Boat, moving boat in the water, or the man running or walking, okay? All these concepts are related with the distance, speed, and time. Many of you might have been traveled to the Mumbai or any other places, from Khed to Mumbai, Khed to Ratnagiri, and many other places in car or train or in aeroplane also. Okay, so the distance which you have covered when you were traveling in car, the distance which you have covered, how much time you have taken, what was the speed of your car, and in that particular speed, how much time you have taken? See, some drivers are slow, they drive the car slowly, so they take more time. Whereas those who drive fast, they take less time, okay? But fast driving is dangerous. Okay, that is the part. Now see here, so speed, time and distance. स्पीड टाइम एंड डिस्टेंस आर दी थ्री कॉन्सेप्ट रिलेटेड टू ईच अदर डिपेंड ऑन ईच अदर. ओके सेम डिस्टेंस इज देयर सपोज फ्रॉम खेड टू मुंबई, खेड टू मुंबई द डिस्टेंस इज सपोज 300 किलोमीटर. यू नो रियल वी काउंट द डिस्टेंस इन किलोमीटर मीटर करेक्ट. डिस्टेंस इट इज वन ऑफ द इट इज लेंथ ओनली डिस्टेंस. सो वी काउंट द डिस्टेंस इन किलोमीटर और मीटर. ओके हेक्टोमीटर डेकामीटर. सो सी टू कवर दिस 300 किलोमीटर टू बॉयज आर देयर सपोज रोहन एंड सोहम. ओके सोहम विल ओके. सो बोथ आर गोइंग इन देयर ओन कार्स. ओके रोहन स्पीड इज 60 किलोमीटर पर आवर, 60 किलोमीटर पर आवर एंड सोम स्पीड इज 50 किलोमीटर पर आवर. हु विल रीच फर्स्ट मुंबई, हु विल रीच फर्स्ट मुंबई, हु स्पीड इज मोर करेक्ट बिकॉज डिस्टेंस इज सेम 300 किलोमीटर. रोहन स्पीड इज 60 किलोमीटर पर आवर. 60 किलोमीटर पर आवर मीन्स what is 60 किलोमीटर पर आवर. The slash means per hour means Rohan covers 60 किलोमीटर in 1 hour. Per hour means 1 hour. Okay, Rohan travels 60 किलोमीटर distance in 1 hour. For example, from here to here there is 60 किलोमीटर. Okay, so this from here to here Rohan cover in 1 hour, whereas Som cover 50 किलोमीटर इन 1 hour. 50 किलोमीटर मीन्स सपोज हियर, सो ही कवर्ड इन हियर 50 किलोमीटर इन 1 hour. दैट इज 60 किलोमीटर पर आवर, 50 किलोमीटर पर आवर. दैट इज हिज स्पीड, स्पीड ऑफ द कार. ओके सो स्पीड इज काउंट इन दिस वे. डिस्टेंस कवर्ड इन 1 hour दैट इज कॉल्ड स्पीड. ओके अंडरस्टूड. सो रोहन स्पीड इज 60 किलोमीटर पर आवर मीन्स इन 1 hour रोहन कवर 60 किलोमीटर डिस्टेंस, वेयर एज सोम स्पीड इज 50 किलोमीटर पर आवर दैट मीन्स सोम कवर 50 किलोमीटर डिस्टेंस इन 1 hour. ओके सो दिस वॉज देयर स्पीड. नाउ द डिस्टेंस इज 300 किलोमीटर, रोहन स्पीड इज 60 किलोमीटर पर आवर, देन हाउ मच टाइम ही विल टेक टू रीच मुंबई. हाउ मच टाइम, how many hours will he take to reach Mumbai. So how to find that time, or see Som speed is 50 km per hour, missing 1 hour, he covers 50 km distance, then how much time he will take to reach Mumbai. So to find that time, we are going to learn this lesson, distance, speed and time, and we will learn that how to find time when distance and speed is given, or how to find sometimes what time will be given. Sometimes what time will be given. Suppose Rohan take 5 hours to reach Mumbai. Distance is 300 km. It is given and the question is Rohan take 5 hours to reach Mumbai. Means he takes 5 hours to cover 300 km distance. Then what was his speed? What was the speed of his car? Okay, that you get 60 km. Understood? So how to calculate that we are going to learn. Now see, generally the longer distance we count in kilometer. Okay, and the smaller distance we count in meter. If we are walking, by walking how much distance maximum we can cover? 1 kilometer, 2 kilometer. Okay, so that can be counted in meter also. And the longer distance, like from Khed to Mumbai, Khed to Ratnagiri, we have to count in kilometer. Okay, so see here, and to cover longer distance, obviously the car will take hours, time in hours, hours, 1 hour, 5 hours, 6 hours. Okay, and to cover smaller distance, we will take minutes. Okay, so when the smaller distance is there, that which we count in meter. At that time, time should be in minutes. Whereas, If the longer distance is there in kilometer, see, the longer distance is there in kilometer, at that time, time should be in hour, okay? And smaller distance is there, which is in meter, then the time should be in minutes, okay? This, there we have to take, when distance is given in kilometer, we will find time in hour, okay? And when distance is given in minute, sorry, in meter, at that time, we will count the time in minutes, okay? And speed will be obviously kilometer per hour and meter per minute. Understood? So see here, there are three formulae in this, three formulae which we have to memorize, keep it in mind. Distance is equal to, distance, in short, we call it D, is equal to distance. To find the distance, what we have to do? We have to multiply the speed, with time. Multiply the speed with time. It's very easy. Okay? Just necessary precautions we have to take, otherwise this calculation is very easy. If speed and time, speed of the car and time taken to cover the distance by that car is given, if speed and time is given, then we can find distance. Just we have to do the multiplication. So three terms are there, distance, speed and time. This is basic formula, distance is equal to speed multiplied by time. In case distance is given, time is given, we have to find speed. Then how to find speed is equal to distance is given, time is given. We have to find speed. At that time, how to find? Distance divided by time. This, see now, distance is equal to speed multiplied by time. Then to find speed, time will come here and it is multiplied here. So when we talk on this opposite side of equal sign, it will be divided. So distance upon time. Whereas when time is given, sorry, when a speed and distance is given and we have to find time at the time, time is equal to distance upon speed. Upon means divided by, distance divided by time, distance divided by speed. Okay? These three formulae write first on the notebook. Distance is equal to speed into time. Speed is equal to distance upon time and time is equal to distance upon speed. Okay. Once you understand these three formulas, means if one formula you know, then three this remaining two automatically you will get. Okay. Write down, pause the video and write down. Okay. Let's move towards the exercise 18. Okay, see, write down the answers which should replace the question marks in the given table. Here one table is given. In that three columns are there, speed, time and distance. Sometimes they have given speed, time and distance we have to find. Sometimes they have given speed, distance and time formulae. In the first question, what they have given? Speed is given. Speed, in short, it is represented by S, okay? So S is what? 30 km per hour. Okay? 30 km per hour means 30 km covers in 1 hour. That is, that was the speed. Time is given. Time in short T. 5 hour. Okay, and what we have to find? Distance. Distance means D. Okay? It's simple, very simple. We have to find distance means first formula. Distance is equal to speed multiplied by time. Speed multiplied by time. Okay? So see here, speed is in kilometer per hour and time is also in hour. Hour is there, fine. Now just write 30 kilometer per hour. Per hour means upon hour. Multiplied by 5. Now see, Don't forget to write these units, kilometer per hour and hours. Okay, now see, just multiply first number 35 are 5 zeros are 0, 5 threes are 15. 150. Now what is our unit you write here? It is distance. What unit you write here? Distance is calculated in kilometer. Okay, so kilometer, but we get here unit automatically with the calculation. How? See, this R is in the denominator and this R is in the numerator. That can be cut. Okay, as we divide numbers, when we divide fraction, we divide numerator and denominator. Remember? So in this way, this R in the numerator and this R in the denominator can be cut. Okay, divided by themselves. So what remain here? Kilometer. Automatically we got kilometer, and you know the distance is always counted in kilometer or meter. Okay, so in this automatically you will get the unit if it is time, whether it is speed, automatically. See now, second, what is given in the second? It is a speed is given, it is in meter. What is that? 25 meter per minute. Means suppose man is walking, one man is walking, he covers 25 meter distance in 1 minute. It is his speed. Okay, and what is given? Distance is given. How much distance he has to cover? 225 meter. 225 meter distance he has to cover. Okay, now see, meter and meter, okay, both the things which are given here, speed and distance, they are in same unit, meter. So we have to find time. Okay, and what is formula to find time? Time is equal to distance upon speed, means distance divided by speed. Okay, so here is equal to distance is what? 225 meter, means to cover in 1 minute he covers 25 meter. Then to cover this 225 meter distance, how much time will it take? Somehow it is the problem of unitary method also. Okay, 225 meter divided by 25 meter per minute. Okay, now see here, division is there, division of fraction is equal to 25 ones are 25, 25 nines are 225, and this meter in the numerator, meter in the denominator will cancel. Here in a minute that will come up, 9 minutes. So he takes how much time? 9 minutes to cover that 225 distance, meter distance. Okay, next, two only problems can be written here. Pause this video, write these two examples. Next, third one, what is given? Speed is not given. Distance is given 6 kilometer and time is given 15 second, and we have to find speed. Speed should be in meter per second. Okay, now see here, the distance is given in kilometer and time is given in second. Kilometer is related with hours. I said you kilometer, when distance is given in kilometer, the time should be in hours, 5 hours, 2 hours, whatever. But time is given in second. So what we have to do? First we need to convert this distance, kilometer, into meter. Okay, there should be meter per second or meter per minute. Okay, so 6 kilometer means how many meter? Remember that triangle of conversion. Kilometer is in the base and meter is 3 steps up. Going up means multiply by 1000, he said. So 6 kilometer means 6000 meter. Okay, now let's find the speed. Speed is equal to again distance upon time. Okay, what is distance? 6000 meter upon 15 second is equal to 6015. They are divisible. If you are not able to divide here immediately, take separate 6000 and divide it by 15. Okay, I'll show you how to divide here directly. Now see, whenever we divide 6000 by 15, we start from this side, correct? So first two digit is 60. So 15 on the 15, 15 4 the 60, correct? And then 15 zeros are 0, 15 zeros are 0. Finish. 400 meter per second. Here meter second. Can we cut that? No. It will remain as it is. 400 meter per second. So his speed is 400 meter per second. In 1 second, per second means in 1 second, he covers 400 meter. That was his speed. Okay. So total distance 6000 meter he covers in 15 second. Okay. So we have found his speed 400 meter per second. Next, the next question is, see. In the next question, instead of speed, time and distance, they have given work, rate and time. Again, same only. Same concepts, work, rate and time. Fourth one, work means W is 480 pages. Here, see, work means which concept out of this? We'll discuss it. Rate means 30 pages per hour and time. See now, here W is work. Work is 480 pages, rate is 30 pages per hour and time we have to find. Okay. Now see, in these three concepts, work means out of distance to time, which will be? Work means, it is similar as a distance. Okay. Rate means it is similar as a speed, and time already it is there. Time you have to find. Okay, time is already there. So see, again same formula. Instead of distance we will use work, instead of speed we will use rate. Okay, so time is equal to work upon rate of work means 30 pages in 1 hour. 480 pages we have to read or write, whatever, it is not given here. But total target is 480 pages. And in 1 hour, how many pages are getting completed? 30 pages in 1 hour. So to complete these 480 pages, how much time is required? That we have to find. So to find that time, we need to divide work by the rate of work. Okay. So work is 480 pages. Upon rate means like a speed, 30 pages per hour. Okay, see this pages cut, 0 0 cut, 48 divided by 3, what you get? 16 3s are 48, right? So 3 1s are 3, 3 16s are 16 hours. How many? 16 hours are required to complete this work with the speed of 30 pages per hour. Okay, 16 hours are required. Getting? See fifth one. So fifth one and sixth one, try to solve by yourself. Okay, fifth one and sixth one, solve by yourself. It is same like this. Use this formula. Whatever is not given, write that here and accordingly swing the formula. Okay. Now pause this video and write these two examples. Two more examples we will see together today. See now. Example number 7. A car runs 10 km per liter of petrol. The petrol tank contains 22.5 liter of petrol. How much distance can it run? This is not actually example of distance, speed and time. It is example of unitary method or simply word problem of multiplication, we will say. Multiplication or division. Okay, see, let us decide what we have to do. A car runs 10 km per liter. Per liter means in 1 liter, it covers 10 km distance work. So, work is 10 km per liter. Work mode is rate. Rate is 10 km per liter. What is meaning of this? That car runs or car travel 10 km distance in 1 liter petrol. Means per 1 liter, it covers 10 km distance. This is it. This is the rate of traveling. Okay. Now, total petrol is, total petrol, the petrol tank contains 22.5 liter of petrol. Means what we can say this work. How much it is? 22.5 liter. Okay, 22.5 liter. Then how much distance can it run? How much distance can it run? What distance will be covered by the car in this? In this total, this 22.5 liter petrol is there in the tank, and its speed is 10 km per liter. Then how much distance it will cover? So obviously, what we can say, total petrol here, not work. Okay, total petrol. Okay. Now see, distance we have to find. So to find distance, what we will do in one. 1 liter petrol, it is covering 10 km distance. Then in this much liter petrol, 22.5 liter petrol, how much distance will it cover? Given for 1 liter, asking for 22.5 liter. Okay. So let's multiply this 22.5 multiply by or 22.5 liter multiply by 10 km per liter. Okay. First only this liter cut, 22.5 into 10. So see, into 10 means 22.5 multiply, when there is multiply by 10, 100 or 1000, what we do? If there is decimal point, we shift it toward this side. Now there is 10, so one place it will come here, that means we get exactly 225. Okay, so the distance is 225 km. So in this 22.5 liter petrol, that car will cover 225 km distance with this rate, 10 km per liter. In 1 liter petrol, it covers 10 km distance. Then in this 22.5 liter petrol, how much distance it will cover? 225 km. Okay. Next, 8th one. Rahu started from Bhusawal to a town 280 km away at 6 am at the speed of 56 km per hour on his motorbike. At what time will he reach his destination? Okay, see here. What is distance? He has to cover 280 km. 280 km means he has to Rahul started from Bhusawal to a town. Means he has to go in another town which is 280 km away from his town Bhusawal. Okay. So he started at 6 am in the morning. What was his speed? His speed is 56 km per hour. Means in 1 hour he is covering 56 km distance. Total distance is 280 km. Okay. Then if he has started from at 6 am in the morning, at what time he will reach in that town? Okay. So means we have to find how much time. First we will find how much time he will take for that journey. Okay. So see, first we will find time. So you know, to find time, we divide distance by the speed. So distance is 280 km upon speed is 56 km per hour. Okay, is kilometer cut with the kilometer 280 divided by 56. I think 56 5 6 are 30, 5 5 are 25 and 3 28. Yes, 56 1 are 56, 56 5 are 280. So the time is 5 hours. Okay, so he takes 5 hours for that journey. This is not the answer of this question. See, what is the question? It is not asked how much time he will take. It is asked that if he has started at 6 a.m. in the morning, at what time he will reach to the destination? Means, see, at 6 a.m. he has started. So, from 6 a.m. count 5 hours. Because he has taken 5 hours for the journey. Okay, so 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11. At 11 a.m. or 11 o'clock he will reach to the destination. So, 6 a.m. he has started plus 5 hours is equal to 11 a.m. So he will reach to the destination at 11 o'clock or 11 a.m. Okay. So in this way, we have to find distance, speed and time. Out of three terms, any two will be given and any two will be given, one we have to find. So accordingly, move the formula. Okay. Three formulae which I have given, memorize them. Understand? And watch this video very carefully, understand the concept. It's very easy. Calculation is very easy, understand the concept just. Okay? So I hope you have understood this. If you have any doubt, ask me during the doubt session. So thank you for today and have a nice day.